got big goggles blues. Big goggles blues. Can't get no boost. Look of you's got big goggles blues. Just meeting the element there. Just about touching on the edges there and that. Oh, look at that. Oh, wow. I wish you could smell these smells. They are absolutely gorgeous. That's the work just going in there, steaming me up. And that is beautiful. I shall be tasting a little drop of that later on when we fill up. And I'll let you know what that tastes like as well.
What we've got here is a heat exchanger, which is a fancy word for a car radiator, effectively. So what we're using this for is a stage where we take our boiled wort, which has had all the hops in. We then pump it through this heat exchanger radiator. And what that does is that it allows us to extract all the energy that we put into the boiling of the beer back into the water that we're going to be using either for another brew, which goes into a hot water tank at the top there, or we use it for cleaning. So it's a very energy efficient piece of kit, this. And the good thing about it also is it allows us to take the boiling liquid down to a temperature which is not going to kill the yeast. So we take it down to about 30 degrees centigrade. And the yeast is then very active and ready to break down the sugar into alcohol, which is fantastic for our point of view. It's a dual purpose piece of kit, really. It's a nice piece of kit and it works very well.
Fantastic, thank you.
What we're doing here is we're just literally taking a sample out of the tank here, and it's easier to do out of the bottom of the tank rather than take it from the top because of all the steam and everything.
Yep.
So we've got some of the wort here. You can see it's very dark, which is well, good use because that's the colour of the Red Panther. You'll see it's cloudy. What we'll do is we'll put some into a nice glass and you'll be able to see it and taste it.
Yeah, brilliant.
Okay.
Right, yeah.
Right, okay, we're just going to pour out some into your glass so you can have a quick taste. I'll try not to put a head on there for you. There you go.
Right, I'm going to kind of do a balancing act with that on there like that and just let you know what that tastes like. It's lovely, lovely and warm. So, You can smell those lovely barley smells on there. Let's have a little taste. Oh wow, that just tastes like it's doing you good.
Like a medicine to me.
Yeah, funny enough, I've not been well lately, and that just it just tastes like like some sort of health drink. You know?
Oh right.
Hmm.
New market for
it's beautiful. It really is beautiful. You got kind of hefty sort of rich biscuity notes in there. Really sweet, but obviously it will be sweet because the sugars in there have yet to be turned into alcohol. A slight bit of chocolatey coffee sort of notes in there, but wow, that is so lovely.
Oh.
Oh, wow. You want to be here, I'm telling you. That is absolutely beautiful.
It's got quite a body in there already, isn't it?
Mm. Yeah. There's a lovely richness, but it's so malty, so lovely and malty. It's got a hell of a lot of character of Horlicks about it, without that creaminess. It's got a big Horlicks-y character. Now, these characters obviously won't be in the finished beer. Well, they will be, but it may not taste of Horlicks, you know what I mean? But at the moment, it tastes really richly Horlicks-y.
Well, the hops will balance the flavours, though, with the malt. I think you'll still get that biscuity taste to it.
That is lovely. That is really good. I can see that doing me good there already.
We've got some Challenger hops that we're going to add to the wort and weigh them out.
With your starter kit bucket.
Thanks, sir. I thought you weren't going to put that in there.
No, sorry about that, but there you go.
I am professional, honestly. Right. Let's break them up a bit. Actually, I'm actually allergic to the hops as well,
usually.
Really? Yeah, I think I do.
I was smelling some the other day and started getting my nose actually was getting clear for the first time ever.
Right.
Not the right job to be in, is it?
No, not really. I usually wear a mask. It's been on the camera.
Yes, he's showing off his good looks. I haven't proposed to him yet, though.
No, I'm a bit scared of that. But you've already taken that, aren't you?
Well, yeah, I don't know, though. He's already married, you know.
Oh, is he?
Yeah. You might be second best.
Oh, right. No. That's always the case.
So
what
have you got there in this one? This is Challenger.
This is Challenger.
Yeah.
I do a blend at this stage. Try and get the right weight. So they're very light, so they don't weigh very much. There's quite a big volume in there. And now we're going to add some North Down.
Lovely.
It's a good combination.
So this is the Black Panther?
No, it's in the Red Panther.
Oh, sorry, Red... Yeah, Do you know what? I've got good memory. You did say that about 8 times already.
You're all flustered about this marriage proposal.
That's what it is.
Vacuum. The hops come in these vacuum bags, and they come like bricks. So they're
freeze like kind of tight in it.
Yeah, very compact. I'm just loosen a few up here.
Yeah.
So I can put them in. Oh, they smell fantastic actually when they're like this.
Oh yeah.
There.
I'm going to do one of my technical zooms straight in.
Yeah.
Wow, look at that. Oh. I've already had my nose in these hops as well, and they smell glorious.
So they smell quite peppery,
don't they? Yeah, what was that? The Challenger, wasn't it?
Yeah.
There's a slight pepperiness there. And the North Down was a kind of a little bit autumn leaves, if anything.
Yeah.
But really beautiful, like, aromas in it.
Right, we're there.
There you go. Technical zooming.
2 kilos.
Lovely.
There we go. So we're ready to add those to the wort once it starts to boil. At the moment, it's at 85 degrees centigrade.
We'll actually do a proper zooming on that one.
Yep,
I
see that.
Yep, 84.5.
Yeah. So we've got an hour or so before that gets up to 10 inches. Well, this is the fermentation tank. You can see it's been clad in insulation. If you ever look inside the tank, you'll see it's a stainless steel tank and it's got some cooling cores around the outside of the outer ring of the tank. And they're there so that we can control the temperature of fermentation. When we put the wort inside the tank, It'll go up to about the top level of those coils.
Yeah.
And it'll be 30 degrees centigrade, so that's great for
now the... Now that will be controlled by this over here, won't it?
Yeah, the control panel. At the moment it's reading 96 degrees because we're measuring the temperature of the wort.
Yeah.
But when we transfer the temperature probe into the beer here,
yeah.
It'll read 30 degrees. And that's great for the yeast because they'll start getting all active and multiplying and stuff. But really, when you want to ferment it, you want to ferment the beer at about 22 degrees centigrade. So that control panel will tell the chiller unit to start pumping cold water through those coils. And then bring the temperature down to 22, and then it'll turn itself off. Quite clever, really.
Yeah, brilliant.
and then as it ferments, it's an exothermic reaction, so it heats up and if you didn't have those cooling coils, then it will go up to a very high temperature and will make the beer taste kind of strange. So you want to keep it around about 22. So those cooling coils will kick in again, or the water around those coils will start pumping water around them about 22 and a half degrees. So you've got plus or minus 0.5 of a degree.
Fantastic.
That's quite precise.
Fantastic. Thank you very much.
So we're all up to the right temperature now, so we're going to add the hops. A simple process of just chucking them in, really. So it's nothing complicated.
Fantastic.
Make sure they get all in there. Yeah. I'm going to give them a quick stir. Just make sure they're all good. In minutes, actually, we're ready to add the second hops. They call them late hops.
Yeah.
The reason being is that you use more aroma hops when you do the late hopping.
Yeah.
And the reason why you don't add it now is because all the aroma will go, because it'll go up the chimney there and outside. So you want to keep some of the aroma, so you do it last thing, really.
And that will be the last lot of hops that go in?
Yeah, the last lot. And
that's in another hour and a quarter?
An hour and a quarter, yeah.
Brilliant.
So these hops are really there to change and make the beer bitter.
Yeah.
And you need that length of time for the temperature to actually change some of the oils and resins and stuff to get them to change to the sort of bitterness.
Great stuff, yeah, because I noticed the north down actually smelt quite floral.
Yes.
Yeah, whereas when you taste it, it's quite dry.
Yeah, well, you probably lose a lot of the floral notes because they're going up the chimney and outside. But they've got a high...
So will you be putting different hops in and on the second?
Yeah, the idea is you have some hops are universal, you can do them in the beginning and the end.
Yeah.
Some are more the aroma ones, there are specific ones that I use anyway. I think this one we're using Fuggles, I think. And
Cascade, and was it?
Chinook.
Oh, Chinook.
Yeah, Chinook. So there's certain ratios I use for those two, just to give a bit more aroma. Just interesting sort of combination, really.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
Okay.
Brilliant. Cheers, mate.
So we're going to just add the last hops, the late hops, chucking them in now.
What are we using there, Martin, for late ones?
We've got some Fuggles.
Wow.
And a small percentage of the Chinook.
Yeah.
Just a nice, interesting combination.
That is an interesting later hop.
Yeah, but it's not normally used.
Yeah.
Finally, works for this one, the Red Panther.
Right? Yeah.
It's probably unique.
Well, I just had a little taste of it, and it was glorious. It was lovely.
Right, it's boiling away nicely. So
good. Now you all notice I'm standing right back just in case he throws a right hander at me, because he's going to start getting very busy now.
Yeah, well, in 10 minutes time we'll be very busy.
Oh right.
Another 10 minutes, yeah.